I'm Hank, and I talk about how things work for my job, and when I do this, I use a lot of big words. Sometimes I have to, but other times I think maybe we only do that to sound like we know lots of things. Randall Monroe of XKCD has written a whole book explaining how things work using only the 1,000 most used words. I really like that book, so I thought maybe we could do the same thing. So here is a look at our star area using only the 1,000 most used words in our language. Our world is big and great, but it is only one of a lot of worlds that go around the sun. The sun is a star, like all the other stars you see at night, but much closer up. And the sun is the biggest thing near to us. Next to the sun, our world looks tiny. We are close to the sun, but not the closest. Closest is a small but heavy world. The sun's power pushed all of the not heavy stuff away from this world, so only the heavy stuff remained. The side that's facing the sun is always very hot, but because there's very little air, the dark side cools off very fast. At night. Second is the hot sky world. It's a lot like our world, but very hot. One reason it's hot is because it's closer to the sun, but it's also hot because it has a really thick sky that warms it like it's wearing lots of shirts. This world is so hot that if you landed there, you would be on fire. It can be even hotter than the heavy rock world. Next is our world, which you know all about. Our world has a moon, and a moon is a world that goes around other worlds that go around a star. Our moon was probably made when a world slammed into our world a very long time ago. Even further out is the Red World. The Red World is my second favorite after our world because it had water like our world when it was very young. It's cold and dry now, and we thought that all of the water on it was ice, but this year we found that there was some water, which made me happy. But because it once had lots of water, and it still has some water, we think maybe it could have once had life on it. Next, we have a large area of small worlds that some might just call big rocks. Only one or two of these worlds are big enough to even be round, but we just sent a spaceboat to one for the first time, which was very exciting. After that are the big worlds. This is where most of the air went when the sun pushed all the light stuff out of the inside of our star area. These big worlds are made of almost all air. The first one is the biggest world, which has a storm so big that our whole world could fit in it. The big world has lots of amazing moons, like the ice water moon, which is warm on the inside and so things might be able to live there. The ring world is the next air world. It's a lot of people's favorite world because it's so pretty. It also has an ice moon and a lot of other really cool moons. The rings are very bright, even if they aren't very thick, and they're made of ice. There are two more air worlds. They're smaller and have more kinds of air, including the kind of air that we pull out of the ground here to warm our houses. That kind of air makes them more blue. The closer of these worlds rolls on its side around the sun instead of spinning like all the other worlds. We don't really know why, but we think maybe some other worlds hit it when it was young and turned it to its side. After the air worlds are the cold, dark worlds. These are small, but many, and made of ice and rock. We just sent our first spaceboat to one of these, and it was pretty much the best day of the year. The pictures are very good. Worlds like these go around the sun very slowly in a big, wide ring. Even farther out, there are a lot of small ice worlds that sometimes get pushed into our area, and as they get close to the sun, the ice burns off, which we can see in the sky. We also just sent our first spaceboat to one of those, which is another reason why this year was great. And the final reason why this year is great is that as of today, this book, Thing Explainer, is a thing that you can buy at all of the places where you would think to buy books. Thank you to the book people for paying us to make this, and thank you for watching this moving picture thing. We hope that you will watch more of them soon.